In our definition so far, we've limited our flow networks in several ways to make our treatment of them a little simpler. Before going any further, I want to show some tricks of the trade that allow all of the theorems and algorithms that we'll study to be applied to more general networks. One such limitation is the need for all the capacities on the edges to be integers. We can extend all our arguments to rational capacities just by multiplying the capacities by the least common multiple of the denominators to create integer capacities. So in this case, I would simply multiply all the capacities by 6. This just amounts to a change of units in our measurement of the flow. Another limitation we've imposed is that no antiparallel edges are allowed in the network. This forces us to choose a direction for the flow between every pair of vertices. In general, however, it might not be clear in which direction the flow should go before solving the max flow problem. It's possible to cope with this situation with some slightly less elegant analysis. Or, just to convince yourself that the theorems still hold, add an artificial vertex between the two nodes and create two edges to simulate a reverse flow in this direction. Another limitation of our model is that we've limited ourselves to having a single source and a single sink. At first, it would seem like we couldn't handle a network like this one, where we have two sources and three sinks. Actually, however, this situation is quite easy to deal with. We can just add an artificial source node and connect that to the others with an infinite capacity, and similarly add an artificial sink. So don't let that limitation trouble you either.